Hello friends and assalamu alaikum. Welcome to my channel IV or Learning Developer. My name is Inshalbing and like previously we have done many of the things using JavaScript and I hope you all enjoy that all things which we have done here. We have covered up many of the videos in part and we have built many of the projects using JavaScript and I hope you all enjoying all the projects which we have done here. So today we are doing another project of JavaScript and we will be learning more other tags in JavaScript. So today I will be telling you what is a object and how to use object in JavaScript and how to create a new object in JavaScript, and we'll be also building a project using this creating a new object in JavaScript. We will be building an amazing image slider using this project here. So this video will be really helpful and I hope you will be enjoying this video because this video will be really helpful and this video will be containing many of the important things. So remember to see this video if you want to learn how to build this amazing image slider using creating a new object tag in JavaScript. And also you can check my previous videos which I have done about JavaScript because that will also giving you help moving forward. And also share this video. After that also hit subscribe button. After subscribing, hit notification bell from which you'll be notified with all the future videos. So now we'll be starting with our video and seeing how to build this amazing project and what are the things included in this, including JavaScript.
So just like I'm telling you, we'll be building an amazing project using JavaScript and we will be using creating an object tag in JavaScript to build this project. So now for building this project here, I will be opening my VS Code. So now when you've opened your VS Code text editor here, I will be opening my folder which I have created already on desktop. And then if I just show you here, this is my folder with the name of creating a new object because this is the tag which we are using in this project here. So I will be now opening my main file and then here I will be just doing one thing, like here I will be now erasing all the main codes I will be getting here because I will be wanting only the codes of like starting code. So here I will be now saving this thing, and then when you're getting these all stuff here, I will be moving these all stuff also. So here I will be moving, then here you have to save, and then you have to move in this file. Here I will be now just pressing Ctrl B. Here you have to open it in your default Google Chrome browser to check your image slider project is now ready. These are the images we will be putting in our slider, and then you are just getting, you can see we are just only getting this thing. So here I will be now doing side by side coding side should be at the left, and at the right we will be getting our interface side. So you can see we are getting these all stuff. So here I will be now just getting this, so it should be bigger. Now when you are getting this, here I will be now moving down, and after moving down here I will be writing a tag which will be like this class. Then here I will be now just writing content, then I will be moving down right here div, then I will be writing class which should be images. Now you have to move down right here image, then I will be writing bg1.jpg, then you have to just move down. Here I will be copying this thing by pressing Ctrl C, Ctrl V, then Ctrl C you have to press, Ctrl V, Ctrl V, Ctrl V, Ctrl V. Now here I will be only changing the image name. Here I will be writing bg2. Now when you've written this, here I will be writing div, and then when you've written this, here I will be moving in this. Here you have to write class. In class I will be writing btm slides. Then you have to just move down right here, span on click is equals to right here btm, then I will be writing here slide, and here I will be writing one like this. Then you have to just move here, and then I will be copying this tag by pressing Ctrl C, then paste it here like this. Then here I will be now writing 5 4 3 2. Then here when you've written this, I will be moving right here div class, then I will be writing here sliders left, then here I will be writing on click, and here I will be just writing side like this, and then I will be writing here slide. Here you have to write -1. Then when you've written this, here I will be just moving down right here span. Here you have to write class which should be fasfa-angle. Then I will be writing here left. Then when you've written this, here I will be doing one thing. I will be just copying this thing from here, Ctrl C, paste it. Here you have to save it, then reload. So you can see we are getting this stuff. Here I'll be taking this down like this. Now when you're getting these all things, here I will be now just doing one thing. Here I will be now just doing one thing else. Like here I will be moving in this tag, saving this thing, and then I will be just writing here sliders right like this. Then here I will be now writing here also right. So simply you have to write here right, save this, then you have to now reload. So here you will be getting these all stuff. You can see we are getting all the images. Just I will be now doing one thing. I will be writing here one, save this, reload. Now when you're getting this stuff, here I will be moving down after the two divs which we have written. So here you can see we have just written this. I will be now closing this tag here by writing div, then I will be moving down. write here script tag. So simply here you have to do one thing, like here I will be writing a script, then you have to write where index value. So here I'll be writing index value is equals to 1. Right here show image, then I will be writing here index value like this. Then I will be now closing it. Right here function btn, right here slide, and then I will be writing here e, right here show image, then I will be writing here index value like this. And when you've written this, here I will be writing is equals to e, and then you have to just move down right here function btn slide, then I will be writing here e, right show image like this, and then in this I'll be writing index value is equals to, but here I'll be writing plus is equals to e. Then when you've written this, here I will be now just moving down right here function right here show image e tag, then here I will be writing like this, then here you have to write var I tag, then right here const image is equals to document dot query selector all, then I will be writing here image. Here I will be moving down, and after moving down here I will be writing const like this, right here slider is equals to right here document dot query selector, then here I will be writing all, right here btn, then I will be writing dot btn, and here I will be writing slides span, then I will be just moving down right here if e, then here I will be writing image dot length like this, then here I will be writing index value is equals to 1, then here I will be writing if e, then here I will be writing 1, here you have to write index value, then here I will be writing is equals to image, and then right here dot length. Now when you've written this, here I will be moving down right here for I is equals to 0, then right here I, and then you have to write image dot length, then I will be writing I plus plus, then you have to just move forward, and here I will be writing image I. Then when you've written this, here I'll be writing style dot display, then I will be just writing is equals to none. Here I will be now moving down right here for I is equals to 0, then right here I like this, right here slider dot length, then I will be writing I plus plus, then right here slider I tag, right here dot style dot background, then I'll be writing here RGBA, so here I will be writing RGBA, then you have to write 255 255 0.1, then you have to now move here, and then after moving down right here image, right here index value, then here I will be writing dash 1 dot style dot display is equals to block, then I will be moving down right here slider, and here I will be writing index value. Then when you've written this, here I will be writing dash 1. Now when you've written this, here I will be writing dot background, then here I will be writing is equals to white. Now when you've written this, here I will be saving, then you have to reload. Now when you will be getting, you can see we are getting all this stuff. Then when you're getting this, here I will be now doing one thing else, like here I will be moving after this tag in this file. Then when you are in this, here you have to now do one thing, here I will be moving right here margin 0, right here padding 0, then when you've written this, here I will be zooming in, then you have to write here box sizing, which should be border box, right here body display, which should be flex, right here align items center, then right here justify content, which should be center, and here I'll be writing text align center. Then when you've written this, here I'll be writing min height, which will be 100 VH, then I will be now just moving down right here dot content, right here height, which will be 400 pixel, right here width 750 pixels, so here I will be writing, then right here position, which will be relative, then right here dot content dot images, then here I'll be writing height 100%, right here width 100%, then you have to move down right here content dot images, right here image, then I will be writing height 100%, then here I will be writing width 100%, then you have to just save this, reload. Now you can see we are getting all this stuff. Here I will be writing dot content dot images. Then here I will be writing so here I will be now just writing dot btm slides. Then right here position, which should be absolute. Then I will be writing here bottom, and then when you've written this, here I will be writing 20 pixel, right here left 50%. Then when you've written this thing, just I will be now moving down right here, transform, translate x, right here minus 50%. Then I will be writing here display flex. Then move down right here dot btm slides suspend tag, right here height 15 pixel. So when you've written this, here I will be writing width, and in width I'll be writing 50 pixel, right here border 2 pixel solid. Then here I'll be writing white. Here I will be now writing margin 0 3 pixel. Then here you have to write cursor pointer. Then when you've written this, here I will be writing dot sliders. Then I will be writing position absolute. Here I'll be writing top 50%. Then I'll be writing transform. Here I will be writing translate y. So here I will be now writing y. Here you have to now write minus 50%. Then I'll be writing here width 45 pixel, right cursor, which should be pointer. Then I will be writing border 2 pixel solid wide. Then when you've written this, here I will be writing background RGBA, right here 255, 255, 255, 0.1. Then I will be writing dot sliders. And when you've written this, here I will be writing hover like this, right background, which should be RGBA 255, 255, 255, 0.2. Then I will be writing dot right. Here I will be writing right 0. Then right here dot sliders, right here span. Then I will be moving down. After moving down, right here line height, which should be 41 pixel. Right here font size 35 pixel. Right color, which should be white. Now save this, and here you have to reload. And when you will be getting, I will be showing you here. You can see our slider is now just ready here. So when you are getting this, here we have to now just see our slider is working or not. So here I will be moving in this. Then you have to just move in this file. Then after moving here, I will be now just doing one thing else. Like here you can see we have just styled these all stuff. Then you have to now move in this, and after moving here, you have to just move here, and you can see. So here you we are getting the values like we have written image here. So here we have to now write these all values. You have to write this. Then after this, you have to save these all things, and then simply have to reload. So you will be getting this. So here I will be now removing, save, and then you have to reload here. So when you will be getting, you can see we are getting a still those thing like we have written. Then if I just show you by full screening this, you can see this is the project. Now if I reload here, so if I just show you, you can see our image is sliding, and this was our project. Here if I press this back arrow, so first front, then back arrow is also working. So this was our project of image slider with toggle button, which we have built using creating an object in JavaScript. And I hope you understand how we have built. If you understand, enjoy this video, so hit a like. And if you want to see more videos like that, so hit the subscribe button. And if you want to see more videos like that, so you can also comment me. You can suggest me what things I should make using JavaScript, and what should the project should I make using JavaScript. I'll be building that in future. So just I'll be meeting you next project with more amazing things and more amazing tutorials. So for today, goodbye.